Yeah, so this vlog is an important vlog to me. I came up with this idea to promote my friend Monica's business, and I did a photo shoot for her recently to help her with pictures for her website, and I just wanted to go ahead and introduce everybody to my friend Monica Flores and to let you see her passion for her business and why maybe you should check her business out. So please enjoy.
Hi, my name is Monica Flores, and I am the owner of Music Tree School of Music here in Pomona, California. We are located at 445 North Garey Avenue, Suite 6 in Pomona. I teach piano and voice here, but we also teach guitar, and we also have a harp teacher. We have 6 different teachers that can service your needs when it comes to lessons. We take kids as young as 3 years old, and we teach you all the way up to adult. So we would love for you to come and check us out. You can look for us on Facebook. You can look for us on Instagram at Music Tree Schools. You can look us up on Yelp and read the reviews about us. But we would just love for you to come and check out our school. And the first lesson is always free. So if you want to come in for a free lesson, give us a call at 951-316-0360. And we'll set up that free trial for you. Hope to see you. Bye. My dream for starting Music Tree actually started when my dad passed away. My dad passed away about 3 years ago. Actually, I don't want to say my dream started when he passed away. I was working for a music school before, and I'd worked there for a couple years. And through working for that music school, I really started to realize that my passion was teaching kids. Yeah. And at the time that I was there, I actually created a program for little ones, and I really, really love preschoolers. And so I took a preschool program and piano and singing, and I kind of smashed it together. And so I had decided that I wanted to start a school actually geared towards little ones. And the night that I decided that, I actually had dinner with a friend of mine that I went to school with, and him and I thought we were going to partner up together and create this school. We sat together at dinner and we created a business plan, and that same night I was super excited. I was a place in my life where my dad was telling me, you know what, let me just send you back to school, because he had seen that I wasn't making money. I had got my car repossessed. Yeah. I had to move in with my best friend at that time, and I went to go work for a different music school, and I worked for that music school, and I told myself, I'm going to work really hard here and I'm going to get a lot of students. But as I was working there, I started to learn how a music school works. And so a year working in, into working there, I really started to gain that passion and realize, like, hey, you know, I want a music school or a performing arts school. This is what I want in my life. And I really wanted also to be able to cater to really young ones. And so, like I said, I met up with my friend, and we came up with a business plan. And that same night, I was super excited. I said, you know what, I'm gonna do this. Like, I made a decision for my life and I'm gonna do it. And it's really interesting, because that same night, the moment that I got in my car, it was in October of 2013, and I got in the car and it was raining, and my little brother called me and he said, Dad didn't come home. And so the night that I actually decided to start a business, I was so excited to tell my dad, hey, like, this is what I've decided. I don't want you to send me back to school to, you know, be a doctor or whatever. I studied music. And the next day I didn't go to work and told, you know, my boss that I needed to go find my dad. And that was the day that we found out that my dad passed away.
Wow.
And so one of the reasons that I opened my music school, I didn't open it right away. Obviously, I was going through the grieving process. Right. You know, I lost my dad and it wasn't easy. But going through the grieving process, the next year, in April of 2014, was when I officially opened Music Tree. I told myself, you know, I need to have freedom for my little brother. So my dad passing away, I actually took guardianship of a little boy, which is my brother, and he was 11 at the time. Mm-hmm. And I told myself, well, I need to have freedom. You know, working for another music school, I was having to work, you know, on their schedule, not my own schedule. And I said, let me just take a leap of faith. I took a leap of faith and started my music school in April of 2014. Passions for this business, oh man, I think there's several. The original first driving passion was really, like I said, having that freedom for my brother, deciding that I could start a business. I mean, I don't know if I'm more passionate about business or more passionate about music, but I know that I'm passionate about being able to bring music to the community. And so being able to have the freedom to take care of my brother, but at the same time do what I love to do and sit at the piano every single day, you know, hang out with kids and teach them about music. I would say, you know, that's part of my driving passion, that my little brother didn't become my excuse, he became my why. That's awesome. Why I wanted to grow a business. And, you know, music is where my gifting was, and I accepted that gifting in my life. And, you know, for a long time, I think I ran away from music and didn't think, you know, that I could really go too far with it, but I made that decision, and now I have Music Tree. And I think now the driving passion is that I ended up opening my music school in Pomona. And I'm on the outskirts of downtown Pomona in this area that is not the nicest area. And people told me, they said, you know, why did you open a music school in Pomona? Why didn't you go to like Irvine, or why didn't you go like somewhere in Orange County where you could charge, you know, a lot of money? And I think God put me in Pomona for a reason. But being in Pomona, you know, my overhead isn't that high and I can keep my my costs low. But I became, or I have become, or I am, I guess you can say, very passionate about being able to, these kids that walk in the door, being able to share with them a classical music foundation that they otherwise may have never had the chance to experience. That they get to come here and it's low cost, it's not right. too expensive, that their parents can afford to send them here. You know, we're in an area where, you know, maybe not that many people would get the chance to experience that. Yeah. That, you know, that because of Music Tree, they get the chance to experience what classical music sounds like, what, you know, jazz sounds like, what musical theater is, and that we get to take those kids and immerse them in that. And so my driving passion has been now to be something in the community, to make an impact on the children here in the community and show them that there is something more. And I think also for me, you know, when I was young or when I was going through, you know, learning music, I didn't have all the self-esteem, I didn't have all the confidence possible and to, I guess, make it as far as I wanted to go. Like I tell myself now, if I had the confidence that I have now, if I had that back in like college, you know, imagine, I guess, how much further I could have went with, I guess, my voice or something like that.
Yeah.
And I realize now that I love being able to teach kids and giving them, you know, that that extra push. That I always say that my job as a teacher is to have confidence in you until you have confidence in yourself. That my job is to believe in you until you believe in yourself. My job is to encourage you until you can encourage yourself. And so just to give you all the tools that you need to succeed as a musician, but not just, and I don't mean that as like, oh, you're gonna go into the industry or you're gonna become this famous opera singer or you're gonna play in this orchestra. More that I want you to succeed in every way as a musician, meaning that it becomes part of your life where I can plant a seed and it can grow, and you can use that to, you know, either express your emotions. You can use that to express your feelings. You can use that as a way to de-stress, just a way mm-hmm. to create something more in your life.
Yeah.
And when I started Music Tree, I chose Galatians 5:22 from the Bible, and I said I want it to be a tree, and I want it to be fruitful music education for children and adults. That when they came in through the studio, that through music, that they were going to feel those fruits, that they were going to feel peace, they were going to feel love, they were going to feel joy, all through just coming to Music Tree. So I would say that those are my driving passions. And also the fact that I just had an idea and now it's growing. We just hit 3 years old and we're on our way to opening our next location, and just thinking that I just had an idea and now I have a team of 6 of us and it was just me, and knowing that like it's growing and it's growing and it's growing, that your visions can get bigger, and your driving passion then gets more, because then you realize that it's no longer just about you. You're impacting like students, you're impacting teachers, you're impacting the community, and you can change. Like to me, I hope to create some kind of culture here at Music Tree.
Just before the dawn, when the light's still gone, shine, shine your way. And you may not know where to go. Shine, shine your way. Open road, but it's still dark. Build a fire from a spark and shine, shine your way. Feed the feeling in your heart. Don't conceal it, then you'll start to find you.